There is always room for a man of force, and he makes room for many. Society is a troop of thinkers, and the best heads among them take the best places. It is not enough to take steps which may someday lead to a goal. Each step must be itself a goal, and a step likewise.
Jerry was a fantastic soccer player, and I know because we used to yell his name a lot from the sidelines when we were cheering. He was really, really athletic, and he was a runner.
In his senior year, he was an All-State. He was an All. Cape and Islands League was the Cape and Islands back then. He was also all Eastern Mass. He was also an all-state forward. So he was on a, and he was actually recruited by some colleges to go play. And then when he applied to the Naval Academy, the coach there, you know, had already talked to him.
We played soccer together. And we ran. I always remember that. I can still remember being out on the playground in winter coats. And when we were kids, we didn't have any North Face gear. We didn't have anything. We had these big convoy coats, they called them, and they practically came down over your knees, and big hats, and everything was wool. And but we were still out there trudging around chasing a soccer ball. So.
The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in a moment of comfort, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy.
Well, this was his second term at the Pentagon. He was asked to come back and serve in the Naval Command Center and sort of right that ship. They had just rebuilt it, and they needed people to staff it, and there were procedures and standards that they wanted to put into place. They needed somebody to come in who was a taskmaster who really would put in the time and the effort to do the things they wanted. When the plane actually hit the Pentagon, he was standing right in the middle of all the action with his second by his side directing everybody to the last moment. So he stood on his command to the very last second he possibly could.
This woman spoke to me at one of the times that we were back there and said, she said, I would not be here today if it wasn't for your son. And I said, really? And she said, we were all crowding down there to watch what was happening on CNN. And she said, he cleared the room. And he said, unless you're working here, out. We have work to do. And he did not do that because he was going to be a hero. He did that because he always did his job and he always cared and did it to the very best.
Even when you've played the game of your life, it's the feeling of teamwork that you'll remember. You'll forget the plays, the shots, and the scores, but you'll never forget your teammates.
I think that as time goes on and the years go by, that people are being born every day, children are being born that will not feel that feeling of what exactly 9/11 was. And I think it's up to us to try to let them know, you know, that this was a horrible event that we never want to see again. Hopefully we never will. And that the people who lost their lives were just like us, and you know, just people who were going to work or doing what they were supposed to be doing, and and we just can't ever forget.
We are concerned that people will not just forget about Jerry, but forget about 9/11. You know, we don't like to be in people's faces. We don't like to, you know, stick our nose and, you know, and say, you have to remember 9/11. But it is our biggest fear. And, you know, here we are, even, you know, so many years removed from 9/11. And we, you know, we're afraid that people are going to forget. My heart never stops beating for you. And long after you're gone, gone, gone. I'll love you long after you're gone, gone, gone.